when I was 14, there was an art exam at school, and I did nothing but flick paint at people and generally draw attention to myself because I was deeply in love with the biology mistress invigilating the exam. And then I saw the clock and it was 20 past three, so better do something. So I did a painting in 10 minutes, and when the results came out, 3 weeks later, I was top of art. So I thought, well, this is worth looking into. I mean, I'm not a painter who started out by painting milk bottles and goes on painting milk bottles for the rest of time. There are people who hate my work, and there are other people who are completely indifferent to it. None of that's up to me. When it's left my hands, and then it has to take care of itself. And if it becomes a controversial thing, which has happened to me, I think it just shows it's got a bit of life to it. You must make your work your best friend, that you can go to it. Whatever you're feeling tired, you're feeling bored, you're feeling happy, you're feeling miserable, you're feeling randy, you're feeling whatever you're feeling, and go to your work and have a conversation with it. And that's how I've lived my life. I know you're not supposed to remember the 60s, but I remember quite a lot of it. I worked consistently in the life room, but I made experiments into op art, into pop art, into all those things. I mean, everything has to be an experiment, otherwise it's dead. It had been in the papers about Aubrey not wanting to recognise its most famous son, and it made me quite cross. I decided I was going to try and do something myself. I sort of made it for, perhaps someone in a bad love affair, wandering lonely by the sea, thinking about life and death and all those big things, that, that conversation with the good old horizon that people tend to have with the sea. It's become, amazingly, sort of a place of sort of pilgrimage. On November the 30th, 2002, I'd driven to the sea, and there was a huge storm raging. The shingle was being tossed, and it was very exciting. And I came back here, and what was inside me was this storm. The sea, I suppose it's a metaphor for life and death. It's also very sexy. I like the way people see in the walls of water, faces, figures, and they're not there consciously. It's just that when you're really in the zone, the muse is really present, and when it's going right, it paints itself. I don't understand any of this business, but I mean, if I did, I don't think there'd be a lot of point in doing it. You're attempting the impossible. That's the point, really.